I'm Garry Adelman with the Civil War Trust War Department, and I'm here with Mark Malloy at the Frederick Douglass National Historic Site. And we're going to try to talk about Frederick Douglass as quickly as possible. You ready?
I'm ready.
When was Frederick Douglass born?
February 1818.
And where did he live?
He was born in Maryland, lived most of his life in Rochester, New York.
And when did he escape slavery?
He escaped slavery when he was 20 years old in 1838.
And where did he go?
He went first up to New York and then to Massachusetts.
He wrote a book, right?
Yes, he wrote an autobiography called The Narrative Life of Frederick Douglass.
Did the book have any ramifications for him in particular?
It did. He made himself a marked man, a fugitive slave he was, so he had to go to England to escape from being captured and resold into slavery.
And did he have to live there forever?
No, he only lived there for a few years until the people of England raised money and then purchased his freedom.
And then where did he go?
And then he went to Massachusetts, and he was up there for a little bit until he moved out to Rochester, New York.
Now, during the Civil War, he came to Washington sometimes, right?
He did. He came down to visit from Rochester. He met with Lincoln three different times during the Civil War.
Did he have sons that fought in the Civil War?
He did. He had two sons, Charles and Lewis, who fought in the Civil War.
Any famous places they fought?
Lewis fought in the Battle of Fort Wagner in Charleston, South Carolina. His son Charles was also engaged around Petersburg.
How do you think Frederick Douglass affected rights for African Americans?
He did a lot to affect rights for African Americans, just through personal example and then his constant efforts to change people's minds through his speeches and writings.
Was he married to one woman?
No, he was married to his first wife, Anna. After she passed away, Douglass remarried a white woman named Helen Pitts, who was 20 years younger than him.
In a nutshell, what did he do after the Civil War?
After the Civil War, he's fighting for equal rights, not just for African Americans, but also for women. He becomes very big in the women's suffrage movement.
How long did he live?
He lived till 1895.
Where did he die?
He died here in the house in the center hallway of a heart attack.
And how did this house come to be in the possession of the National Park Service?
It was converted over in 1962. President JFK signed it into the National Park Service.
And lastly, is there something cool about Frederick Douglass you'd like to add?
Yeah, he was a really athletic guy. He used to sometimes walk from here to the Capitol. He had gymnast rings on his front porch. We have his barbells he worked out with every morning on the front yard. And when he was 70 years old, with a little help, he climbed to the top of the Great Pyramid in Egypt.
Very, very cool. Mark Malloy, thanks for joining us, and thank you for watching.